In Ecuador, they are currently operating two mobile hospitals for medical assistance MED-1, moving through different cities around the country. These units are characterized by their ease of transfer from one place to another, the quick installation process becoming operational in 30 minutes from arrival at the required point with equipment and cutting-edge technology. Every year, thousands of people die victims of medical absence for one simple reason. They do not have access to basic health service, or existing services do not have space or capacity for assistance, as they are saturated by users. Serious events require swift medical solutions. To this end, these mobile hospitals have been created to provide immediate health solutions at any critical point where needed. Mobile Health Unit MED-1 have contributed to the relief of the congestion in medical centers and hospitals in Ecuador, allowing a more fluid, agile attention and with state-of-the-art equipment. Responsiveness is immediate. As soon as a hospital reaches a certain place, a well-trained 8 professional team takes only 30 minutes to set the equipment installed. After this time, the unit is automatically ready to start the work. Designed by health professionals, these hospitals are prepared to provide quality medical assistance. Each unit operates as a modern hospital center and can provide service 365 days a year. Thus, people can receive assistance in preventive medicine, ambulatory medicine, emergencies, general medicine, laboratory, radiology, gynecology, internal medicine, surgery, and intensive care. The unprecedented flexibility of the design of MED-1 allows an infinite variety of configurations. With anchor trailers and working under burning sun weather, the professional team of MED-1 installs the mobile hospital structure comprised of beams and columns made of a special olivated alloys, on which an anti-flame shelter system will be extended, covering the units and the environs to leave them completely sealed tight.
It takes approximately, when everybody's properly trained, training adds about 5 times as much length to the tank. When everybody's properly trained, it takes about 8 hours to 10 hours if everybody knows their job and the weather stays with us. If the weather starts to get too windy when we're setting up the tent, we sometimes need to take a break. Obviously, if it starts to rain, it can slow us down. But in good weather, 8 people, well-trained, 8 to 10 hours, and we're ready to go.
The shelters are designed for a large-scale emergency. Each unit can accommodate up to 200 beds for ambulatory medical assistance and hospitalization. In 8 hours, the area is ready to receive patients. Pioneers in achieving full mobility, MED-1 has considered a total autonomy in the design of these units, thus ensuring efficiency in any place where their services are required, even their remote. For this purpose, MED-1 counts on redundant power generation systems and vacuum systems, storage of pure water and sewage. This ensures capacity to supply 3 working days before filling.
Again, it carries its own water and its own waste tank, and it's fully ready to go just like the hospital is. It has its own water and its own waste. So you get somewhere, you don't have to wait to get hooked up to water, you don't have to wait to dump through the waste, you've got storage tanks for each one.
A satellite antenna enables continuous communications. It also allows medical professionals to access to satellite data and computerized records. Fluorescent lighting, heating and air conditioning with air circulation systems that complement the units. The mobile hospital also has support trailers that contain equipment and supplies needed to furnish the unit, in addition to pharmacies and rest areas for medical staff, with bathrooms and rest lounge for doctors, with all elements and equipment necessary to provide comfort.
This is the first time in the world that MED-1 has been used in a public health model, so pat yourselves on the back. And what we hope to do with this in the future, and how Ecuador is a great program and a great country to make this happen.
The two mobile medical units currently available in Ecuador have become the first of their kind in Latin America. And thanks to their features and ability to move, they allow greater access to health service for the residents of urban areas, and especially rural areas, demonstrating in that way their universality, the ability to be present wherever their services are required, something never seen before in Latin America. So far, the two mobile hospitals acquired by the Ecuadorian government have attended more than 70,000 people in 5 months. The MED-1 service would not be completed without the mobilization of an experienced team of health professionals who complement the project and train local staff, which will take care of the mobile unit.
Hoy y mañana vamos a estar en esta capacitación, que es importante para todos.
Anestesióloga.
Soy auxiliar de servicio.
Soy enfermera.
Enfermera especialista en medicina crítica.
Especialidad en medicina transfusional.
Yo soy médico intensivista.
Personal administrativo.
Soy anestesiólogo.
Soy cirujano general, laparoscopista,
licenciado en el laboratorio clínico.
What I'm going to do this morning is just show you some basic equipment that you might be asked to use. A lot of it's not at the physician level, but in a disaster, you may be asked to deploy some of this equipment and know how to operate it. So we want to give you just a good working knowledge of the equipment, but you also get a good knowledge of some of the critical intensive care equipment.
Training of doctors is made in a continuous basis, adapting it to a local emergencies to respond efficiently to the needs of the population. MED-1 team provides professionals in charge a thorough preparation on the operation of the units and his daily maintenance, as well as knowledge for the operation and daily care of the medical equipment. The mission has ended. Once the general training program for personnel is finished, the mobile unit has been ready for operation. As of now, it only remains to get to work to fulfill the ultimate goal: to bring user quality medicine, to respond swiftly, efficiently, and on a timely basis to health needs of the population.